Welcome back to this very special episode of Young Turks, where we bring you all the action from Tie the Knot. Two down and three ventures to go. Will the founders from Story Express, eChemex and FT Cash make the cut? Let's take a look.
Hi, I'm Ankit Mishra. I'm the co-founder of Story Express, which is a cloud-based video creation tool for businesses to create video content quickly and easily. At Tie the Knot, we are looking to raise 2 crores in exchange for 15% equity. In consumer space, there is Vine, there is Instagram, there is YouTube, there is Facebook. But what it has for businesses, right? So there are researches which tells you that if you are using a video, it improves the conversion and increases the sales conversion by 52%. Why businesses don't use videos often? When we went around and asked this question to a lot of businesses, especially small and medium businesses, the most common answers that we got were, creating a video is time consuming, it's a costly process, so if they go to a professional, they charge a lot of money, which they don't really have. So this is the problem that we are trying to solve at Story Express. So our solution is as simple as choose a video style. So we have variety of video styles based on for various business verticals. You upload the content and your video gets created automatically in a matter of few minutes.
So 2 crores for 15%, right? Investors, questions.
How long does it take you to make a template and what goes into that?
So probably a pair of designer and developer can develop a simple template in 3 days, and a more complex template can probably take 15 days or 20 days. So.
Do you have any competition, if not in India, maybe outside, you can give an example of? What value they are, what stage they are?
Okay, so there is a one company called Shaker Media. So they are based out of Korea and they have recently raised about $3 million from 500 startups and one Japanese fund.
You mentioned your pricing in US dollars. Right. Are you targeting the US markets or the Indian markets?
So, I mean, video has always been preferred by the US guys or UK guys, right? So so we are targeting that market. So for example, we also launched a Shopify application which allows Shopify store owners to create video product videos. So without even any promotion or something, like, we have got about 200 users already using that.
As I understand from the social media perspective, that video is only probably 10% of consumption in social media, whereas 90% goes picture way.
Okay.
Is that not really conflicting with the interest of the business itself?
I'll just quote what Mark Zuckerberg said in last town hall. So he said that all the content 10 years ago on internet was web. Last 5 years it has been images, and the next 5 years would be the videos and the animation, and after that it would be virtual reality. So I mean, next 5 years is the time for us to grab the market.
I guess Mark knows his marbles. So guys, we are talking of 2 crores for 15%.
I'm going to pass. I think it's a very tough market. I think because of SMEs are really hard to sell to, to get to. It's like a tools devil's market.
So tough market, tough SMEs, a pass.
Yeah, same thing. I'll pass.
I'm very interested, but I think the valuation's a little high.
So interested, but valuation, he can't even go and talk to somebody else. We'll get him a mirror.
So I'm interested. Subject to correct valuation, and I can fund up to 25 lakhs.
I would like to explore this further too.
I would also like to explore it further.
Four!
I was about to say, look, if I have other people, I'll look at it, but I do, so yes.
Same here, I just want to understand a little bit more.
Sure. Wow! Seven!
I'll join the board.
Okay, 8 people are interested, guys. So, congratulations, Ankit. They are interested to talk about it, I guess, 5%. Okay.
Thank you.
Congratulations. All good.
So I think that this concept will work, subject to some business model tweaking, which we investors can always do.
Once they've built out the templates and they've got the customers they need, they will become cash profitable very quickly, which is rare these days.
Everybody's has a mobile, you know, and people are really looking into videos as a platform to promote themselves. So I think video is the future.
Hi, I am Amit Agarwal, co-founder of eChemex, India's first real-time chemicals marketplace. We are looking to raise 3 crores at a dilution of 18%. eChemex will be India's first real-time chemical marketplace. We'll be bringing sellers and buyers together on the same platform, leading to market consolidation and convergence of the market. There will be real-time price discovery for all users. Thereby, buyers can buy with confidence,
and sellers will be benefited by lower transaction costs. If we talk about the industries which are using chemicals in big way, it's pharmaceuticals, adhesives, inks, paints, chemical process industry, plywood, laminates, and the list can go on and on. While we move ahead, our one-year goal is to get 1% market share of the bulk chemicals, which is $500 million, which will generate a revenue of $1 million for us.
I think what you have identified is a very big opportunity. I'm not very sure if your response is commensurate to the opportunity as I sense. You're very low on specifics as to exactly how.
What's your business model? Where do you make money?
So we make money on each and every trade which is there.
But you don't settle the trades.
Pardon?
You don't settle the trades, but you make money on the trades.
Yeah.
How do you know
so
people will
the
lie?
The seller will be giving us the money on whatever trades are happening on the platform.
Okay. Second question. I think it's just a segue from what one of my colleagues talked about. What's the money you require?
So we are
3 crores for 18%.
I think you need 300 crores. And if you can show me what that plan is, a lot of people will be interested, but I don't think it's 3 crores.
I know it's not 3 crores, but I am always open for more.
Good one. Good one, Amit.
Just actually the extension of that question, just to make sure I understand this correctly.
Yeah.
This is a listing platform, so basically you are connecting the buyers and the sellers. Is that what you're doing?
Yeah, we will be connecting the buyers and sellers.
3 crores for 18%.
So I'll give it a pass for now.
My heart says yes, my brain says no, I'm going to listen to my brain.
I'll pass, but I think you need work to do to develop this further.
You have some work to do, Amit. They think it's a big opportunity. They think you need 300 crores only because you're asking for 3. They don't want to give you so little money. So all the very best as you take it
Thank
to the
you.
Next level. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. It was a tremendous experience for us. I will never forget this. The B2B sector as such is not so in with the investors. As far as pitching goes, I thought I was very good. But maybe it's their loss, not mine.
Hi, I'm Sanjeev Chandak, co-founder at FT Cash. We are empowering the micro merchants with the power of mobile payments. We are looking to raise 3 crores at an equity dilution of 15%. So what's our vision? Our vision is to empower the underserved micro merchant with the power of mobile payments. Whether or not it is paying to your milkman or for your veggies and stuff like that, right? So what we said was, we want to empower these guys with the power of technology that we have. And once they make the payment, FT Cash receives the money in the nodal account at a partner bank. So the money stays with the nodal account. So from a regulatory perspective, we are compliant. And we transfer the money in their bank account the next day.
So what's our business model? It's fairly simple, uncomplicated. For the merchants, it's 1.8% commission per transaction. Nothing to sign up. For the customers, there is no charge, except in certain categories like newspaper and milk, where the merchants are not going to be paying us.
Any kind of licensing required by you from RBI?
So we don't need a license from RBI because we don't hold people's money in our bank account.
But you told that you will be transferring the money next day.
The bank has complete information from an audit perspective, and also the T+1 settlement is standard even if you go to a store and swipe your card. So the money is anyways received by everybody who's using credit cards and debit cards in the following day. Some people actually have T+2-day settlement, so we're in fact one of the fastest, or the fastest that is there in the market.
So FT Cash looking for 3 crores for 15% of the company.
I like the idea, I'm in.
You're in, so one in.
I'll pass.
Okay, one in, one pass.
I'll pass.
Pass, two pass.
I'm in.
2-2.
So I'll be interested at a lower valuation, but not at a current valuation.
I'm in, subject to current valuation.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm probably standing where he does.
I'm already in.
You're already in. Okay.
I think, we can discuss that offline. That's not a problem.
Discuss the valuation with them. But congratulations, you've got 3 crores. What you started with 15%.
Thank you.
May it be at a reasonable number.
It's a sunrise sector, it's on payment, it's digital. So I think that's purely growth, investment, value play.
Team, again, is really phenomenal. It's probably one of the best startup teams ever that we've seen.
So there are a few bets where you take on the product, there are a few you take on the space, there are a few you take on the team. So this one was definitely the team.
Congratulations to all the teams, and we do hope that you managed to stick your ground during the offline chats. We will be back next year with a new setup of startups and investors to continue this real-time funding game. With that, it's time for us to wrap up this edition of Young Tech. Tell us what you thought of our show. You can tweet us using hashtag YTTithe and off. My Twitter handle is @ShireenPan. Till then, from everyone here on the team, goodbye. Many thanks for watching.